semua rakyat Malaysia. 20-11. 2. 3 dari Azlan. Malaysia emas.
Hello and Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Fakhruddin bin Ma'ruf. People call me Pudin. So today I'm going to show you how to play sepak takraw. Let's go.
Sepak takraw or kick volleyball is a Southeast Asian sport where players use their feet, knee, chest and head to touch and control the ball. Sepak in Malay word which means kick, whereas takraw symbolizes the woven rotten ball used in the game. The game has also a lot of resemblance with games like foot magnet, foot volley, football, tennis, jianzi and sepak. A fun game with huge popularity around Southeast Asia, this game has a lot of resemblance to that of volleyball in case of rules and game sets. This tutorial will let you know about the rules and the procedure of playing the game.
First of all, we need to wear a pair of sports attire that suit on sepak takraw.
I wore a pair of comfortable sports attire to play sepak takraw, which are jerseys and shorts.
For the show, there are several brands that sepak takraw players choose, such as Nanyang, Warrior and Redam. I'm choose Nanyang brand because it's comfortable and flexible one. For the ball, sepak takraw ball shall be spherical, made of synthetic fiber or one over layer. This is how it looks.
Before we start any sports activities, we need to do some warming up to avoid injuries while playing.
There are few basics of controlling ball in sepak takraw. The first technique is Sepak sila.
Sepak sila or an inside kick is the most basic form of kick performed by sepak takraw players. It is mostly used to control the ball. To perform this shot, players usually have to stand with their feet apart, and then while bending their supporting leg a little, they need to hit the ball in upward direction using the inside of the other leg.
For the next technique that we call sepak sudu.
To perform this shot, players need to stand in a comfortable position. Main foot behind and supports leg in front. Contact the ball above the front of the feet. Follow the kick off and swing the main foot towards the ball forward. The knees are bent a little and weight transferred to the support leg.
Now, we move to the position. First, we have tekong, feeder and killer. Now, we go to tekong.
The main job of the server or tekong is to serve the ball. The tekong usually hits the ball with high speed across the net with great speed, making it difficult for the opponent players to defend.
For the next position is feeder.
Feeder, who has the maximum control over the ball during the match. He is the most agile and responsive player in the team. The main job of the feeder is to set the ball in a suitable way for the striker to kick hard past the net. He can also hit the ball across the net. The server usually stands in the back, whereas the striker and feeder take the front left side and front right side.
For the last position in this game,
the striker or killer is responsible for executing the volleys into the opponent's side with high speed. When the striker does not possess the ball, he usually tries to block high kicks from the opponent's side. Various types of spiking can be done, such as roll spike, sandbag spike and taping spike. To master these spiking skills, players must have high flexibility, power, agility and strength. Lastly, don't forget to do cooling down after playing sports. I think that's all for my video on how to play sepak takraw. So I close my video with the moment of the Asian Games 2018 final match, Malaysia against Indonesia, and Malaysia was the champion at that time. Thank you.
20-11, kita di match point, kita di mata emas, kita di ambang untuk meraihkan lagu negaraku berkumandang di Jakabaring. Bangun semua rakyat Malaysia. 20-11. 2-3 dari Azlan. Malaysia emas.
right?